dry paints have a much thicker texture, which makes them ideal for dry brushing, a technique used for quickly highlighting raised and textured areas, such as fur and chainmail on your miniatures. And in this video, we're going to show you how to use them. For the purpose of this video, we'll be using Niblet Green, a bright green dry paint. We'll be doing this over a model based in Caliban Green and shaded with Nuln Oil. You can see how and why we base and shade our models in our previous videos, so feel free to check those out. First, we're going to use a Citadel small dry brush and dip it into our Niblet Green. Then we're going to take some paper towel and gently remove some of the paint from the brush. We will be doing this in a circular motion for a few seconds, until we can see just enough paint on the brush. This might look counterintuitive, but this is how we remove some of the moisture from the paint, and also make sure we don't have too much paint on the brush either. This gives us control of how much paint we can apply to the model. Now we're going to apply the dry paint to our model here. There are two ways we can dry brush our models. The first is by using brush strokes in a back and forth motion, just like how we're dry brushing over our Space Marine here. This is a great way to pick out the straight edges of the armour. It's also great for painting large terrain too, just like this boarding actions terrain piece here using Astaroth Red. The second way we can dry brush is with circular motions. This works really well for models with lots of texture, such as skin and fur. We prepare our brush just like we did before. Then we apply the paint with circular movements, just like our Fenrisian wolf here. This gives us a great highlight for all those little hairs and the skin. Now that you know how dry paints work, why not give it a go on your mini? If you want more help getting started with painting, check out our Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos. We hope to see you soon and enjoy your Warhammer!